Hi, this is Mary. I'm going to show you how to use the bead string. For the video, I'll make it small so we can see it, see all the beads. If you look in our free PDF ebooks, you can see all the different ways to make a string up to 200 feet or longer. You can put all different colored beads on it. Red you like to have close for close vision. It works with your brain hemispheres and your close vision. And blue is good for far. And you can get into the other colors. These all line up about 20 feet to practice and space them out on the string from close to far. And then I also have these for close vision, a close reading vision bead string for presbyopia cure. You're supposed to get it between the eyes and at eye level. Move it down a little bit, and I just look at one bead at a time, back and forth, and blink and relax, and I can shift on a bead. And that'll give you nice, clear, close vision, along with our correct vision habits card. Did I do that wrong? Red should be close. Put the red closest to you. And I don't have a purple bead, but it's nice to have a nice dark purple, then light purple as you go farther out. It's hard to get it lined up in the camera. I know this is between my eyes when I'm looking at it, but with the camera here, it's hard to show it in the video. So just make believe this is perfect here. When you do it yourself, you'll have it perfect. This video also shows me trying to line it up in the camera. I just kept the whole video in there, but the object is to get it between the eyes. When I don't look at the camera, it comes in straight. Between the eyes at eye level. And you can move your beads way out. Anyway, you can use buttons. If you don't have beads, just throw some buttons on a string. I'm looking at the first button and I'm shifting on it. Touch your nose, move it out a little bit. It's best to tie it to a pole, like if my hand was a pole, to hold the string up so you don't have to hold your arm up so you don't get tension. It travels into your neck and your eyes. But we're just showing you this here, so we'll go with as it is. I'm looking at the first bead and I'm shifting on it from part to part. I look at the far bead, I'm shifting on it from part to part, then the middle, back and forth. Then you do both eyes together, one eye at a time, both eyes together again. Little extra practice with an eye that might be a little less clear, or there might, if you have a strabismus problem. And if you've seen in our other videos, you can use an eye patch. This is the eye patch hat. Okay, now I'm using one eye, line it up. May not look perfect in the video because I don't have it in front of the camera here. Like I said, if you want to watch me film sideways, still between the left and right eyes, eye level, I'm looking at the beads close and far. Then just switch to the other eye. Close and far, close and far. Always end with both eyes together again. And you can do this. Camera's off. You can do this close, middle, and far. Look at a close bead, then a far bead, then a close, then a far, then a middle, then a close, far. In any order you want, on three to up to 20 different colored beads or more. Way often on a rope, if you like, up to 200 feet away. See how far you can see it? Do your nice, relaxed, correct, natural vision habits. Shifting, central fixation. I like to call it centralizing. I learned that from my teacher, Thomas Quackenbush. The word central fixation makes some people think it means to fix your eyes immobile on a point. What it really means is to look at one small part at a time, and your visual attention, you just move from part to part, object to object, wherever you're looking. That's your central field. It just moves with your eyes. You can read about that in the books, free ebooks, or in our videos. It describes it in more detail. When your eyes are relaxed and in movement, Everything's nice and clear. Okie dokie. So, I just throw this other video in and you guys can practice. Get another person. One person holds it to their nose and out a little bit. If you hold it on your nose, it restricts your head movement. So you move the string out a little bit after you get it lined up. And the other person on this far end here, on the blue side, or 20 feet, will hold it to their nose and you guys can line up straight in front of each other. And your beads will be in a perfect alignment and you can practice switching back and forth on them. Okay, actually I wasn't going to do a video. I guess you can tell I'm not that organized. I'm actually putting this in the new book for you guys. So, we'll make a big long video sometime this year. It's going to show absolutely everything there is to know about natural eyesight improvement. And it will all be on YouTube for free. Adios amigos! Bye bye!